Yo, 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 what's going on, everybody? If you don't know, if you're new here, I am CPA Strength. I am the strongest licensed CPA in the state of Florida. What do you do, buddy? I educate, motivate, and inspire by teaching accounting on a daily basis, the building blocks. I like the basics because it all goes on that, but I am a CPA, so I am one of the 500,000 of them. Some say I might know what I'm talking about, but anyways, man, I want to get into this one. This one's going to be really fun. They're all really fun. If you happen to be new here, I always say if you happen to be new, you know, if you happen to be sticking around for a while, what up, what up, what up? Thanks for coming back. Don't we have a lot of fun here? I know we're trying to stay positive. We're trying to, you know, I'm trying to grow my channel. I'm trying to give good content. I'm sure the majority of people here are trying to better themselves in some degree, learn more about their business. They're trying to pass a class, whether they want to be an accountant or not. They might have to take a business class. And the list goes on and on and on. Oh, job application. They might have an accounting test on a job. Whatever the case may be, we're here to better ourselves. And so, yeah, I mean, sometimes, you know, I got a certain schedule that I'm grinding on. You know, like a daily video. So sometimes I have to just really just push myself to make these videos. Sometimes I don't really feel like it. Like I'm sure you don't really feel like studying right now. Maybe you do, but I'm sure there's, maybe I'm catching somebody who doesn't want to study right now, but they're just like, oh, they're pushing through. And I'm kind of fun. So you're like, oh, let me see what CPA Strength is all about. Let's get into this, man. I'm sorry. Anyways, that's for the returning people. If you're new, I have the best place in the world over here at the best accounting playlist in the world. Make all your dreams come true. But I've already talked enough, so let's get into this one. This is also my classic series. I think your boy's kind of getting big, though. Boy's getting jacked, son. Is that what 5 years will do? It's 5 years of straight lifting, dog. Bring it, you. Whew. I mean, I can just lie about how rich I am, right? I mean, I gotta look juicy. Anyways, this one is number 72, target profit, all right? Basically, it's definitely a play on break even. It's definitely after fixed and variable cost and contribution margin. And if you noticed, I get better at learning the accounting as I'm teaching. You know, the very first video I did was about fixed and variable cost. And then the next one was about contribution margin. And then everything break even point, the examples on that, target profit, and how to figure that as contribution margin. There's other formulas like, I think, margin of safety and this and that, and all kinds of formulas that go with the contribution margin. So the contribution margin is very important. So I don't really wanna, I've already gone a lot of time, so we just wanna get into this one, this problem here, right? This is the target profit. This is my classic series, right? Target profit number 72. 72, can you believe it? The thing is here, we want target profit. We want it. We've already done break even. We already know the formula for break even, and we're gonna do that real fast. So, but we don't want to break even. We want to make some money. We want to make $50,000 this year in profits. All right. We want to make $50,000 profit. So, how many units are we gonna have to sell for that? Well, how much do we make per unit first? How much do we make per unit? Well, our contribution margin is 80, so that's how much we'd make per unit. So then we make 80. We make 80 a pop, right? We make 80 a pop. And how many $80 do we have to make to cover our other expenses, which are fixed costs, which is like our rents and stuff? Is how many of these $80 units do we have to sell in the 200? To cover our $240,000 fixed costs. And that's the break even right there. And I'm just kind of going over break even real fast, but I just did, this is 72. So 70 and 71 was break even and break even example. So I don't want to get into that again. I'm sorry. So if you don't know what the break even is, go back to the other ones, please. With this, with the fixed cost being $240,000, the unit selling price being $140, the variable cost being $60 per unit, that's how, this is the break-even formula here, fixed over contribution margin, that, and then fixed, and then contribution margin is sales minus variable, and so that is $240,000 fixed over the contribution margin, which is $140 minus 60, which is 80, which happens to be 3,000 units. You have to sell 3,000 units because you make $80 a pop. So if you sell 3,000 of these widgets at $80 a piece, 80, I'm making 80. You have to sell 3,000 to cover this $240,000. And that's break even. So that's nice to know, but I'm sure you're not spending all your time just to break even because, let's say, you know, you've got bills, right? The bills don't necessarily care that you're starting a new business and you're just breaking even right now. They're like, we don't give a F about that. So you're like, okay. We need to sell 3,000 units to break even. Now, how many would we have to sell to, make $50,000? I think that's a good question, and I want you to kind of analyze this. Sorry, I did realize I wrote this expression here because I told you on the other break even, you would always want to check this. If I said three, because break even is revenues equals costs. If you had 3,000 units, you'd want to plug it in here. 3,000 units times $140 a unit, that's $420,000 of revenue equals 60 times 3,000 is the variable costs. That's what, $180,000 plus $240,000. So I'm sorry, but this specifies, 3,000 units specifies the revenues equal costs. I want that to be shown. What do you think you would do to make $50,000? There's a whole formula and stuff, but let's just think. And it's fun to see because think about how many units it took 3,000 widgets just to break even. Now, like, how many is it going to make to do $50,000? I think it's kind of interesting because, see, you've already satisfied all your fixed costs with this break even. You've already paid all your rent and all your other costs. So now every sale before it was $80, and that was just going to your fixed, to like your rent or those $240,000 of fixed costs. But those are paid for. So now that we've broken even, every sale is profit, is $80 profit. So I would just do 50,000 divided by 80, which happens to be 625. See, that's kind of amazing. That I think it's kind of amazing that you, not amazing, but it's just interesting to me. And you know, I want you to kind of think about it like that, and then if it makes sense to you on like not such a fast level, because I really think people just go so fast and they're like, what's the answer, and then it's like you'll never learn it. So I just think I like to just go deep, not worry about anybody else, and you know, think about it. Well, that's considering you have time. Sometimes you have to go super fast. Hold on one second, let me make sure. Yes. In total, you'd have to sell 3,625 units to profit $50,000. But break even is 3,000, and then you just gotta sell 625 more to make that money. Or another method you could do if you just want to get the target profit real fast would be add the target profit right here, 50,000. And that would be what, 290,000 over 80. Let's see, is that 290,000 divided by 80, 3625. Well, you know what, I hope everyone understands the target profit. I'm getting a little bit sweaty. What can we say about the target profit? I think it's pretty easy. I think it's once you know the contribution margin, once you get the break-even method. Do I have anything on the positivity level today? No, I was feeling like more than usual today. Like, I'm kind of like, what are you doing with yourself? Like, you're wasting your time. Like you're never gonna make it big on YouTube. Like, why do you try? And blah blah blah. And I don't know why I have those negative feelings, but I just gotta like know what I really want and just push through things. So I just wanted to say, you know, some people look to me as for motivation or inspiration, as well as the education. And a couple videos before, I said, you know what, I'm gonna accept that role. If I do inspire you, I've accepted it. That was like a month ago. And so I think about that. And I just wanna say, you know, sometimes I have my bad days, of course. Sometimes I don't want to do it. I feel behind all the time. I feel like my videos aren't good. All these things, but I made a goal to myself, and I'm going to be professional about it. And the goal to myself was I'm doing a video a day till the end of the year. So that's like for like, I don't know, 5 or 6 months, a video a day. Anyways, I thought maybe I would try to talk a little bit at the end. So I've already given the lesson, and then, you know, you can stick around for me to blah blah blah, or you could leave. I think that's better, but sometimes, I mean, this is all like freestyle pretty much. The whole video is just freestyle. So before I keep you any longer, I hope to see you in the next one. I hope to see you in 73. I do have something planned, especially for the next little bits. So I hope to see you in that one. Anyways, stay positive. Be nice to people. That's my new thing, man. Be positive, yes, but that's hard. But you know what? You know what I tell myself? Be nice. Like, when I'm in, like, so a lot of times I'm like, you know, and I'm just like, yo, just be nice, dog. Like, just be nice. Like when I see somebody, just smile and say hi. Like, hi. Just, like, so I want you to be nice. Be positive and be nice, all right? Have a great day. Have a great night. Let's get it. Peace.
Too big. Get the Mac off too quick for you to do shit. Got bread, plus these bitches love to ride the broomstick. No short stopping. The flow so popping like a new debit card with a platinum and gold option.